It's time for The Match Game, Hollywood Square, our quiz from Hotel Nathan Cook. From Night Court, Richard Moll. McLean Stevenson. Nedra. And Reilly. And the star for the Match Game, Hollywood Square's hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
All right. Aren't we a good-looking bunch? Everybody's wearing a tie and everything. You're all beautiful. Beautiful.
I love your tie, Gene, really.
Thank you. I haven't worn a bow tie in years. I like these once in a while. You ever wear them, Charles?
I wore them in a play once. That's why I make them that way, too.
What play was that?
Well, Rudy Valley was my uncle, and he used to wear them to work, so I would have to dress like he did.
Oh, how to succeed in business
so
without
I would
really
wear
trying.
The same bow tie he did.
I remember that,
and that
play.
That story in a dime will get you a beer in St. Louis.
Charles was wonderful in that show on Broadway. I'll never forget that performance. Are you all quite ready to have a go at it?
Oh, we certainly are, Gene.
Rather,
all right.
Rather.
Let's begin by greeting our two players here. They are Lynn Klein and Terry Shoden. Is that right? Okay. Hi, Lynn.
Hi.
Want to hear about you first? We'll get a little bit about her life.
I'm from Los Gatos, California.
Los Gatos?
Yes, and I'm a business consultant there, and I'm visiting some friends in this area.
Well, welcome to the Match Game. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Now we're going to hear about Terry.
Hi. I live in Fountain Valley, California. I'm currently a full-time student. I love the beach. I love to water ski.
Are you a good water skier?
No, just starting to learn. Yes. Trying hard, though.
Be careful. It's fun, but it can be a little dangerous. We'll begin by playing the Match Game. You'll each have three chances to match as many of the stars as you can. The winner will go on to challenge a returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Lynn won the toss. That means she'll go first.
I'll choose A, please.
A is what you want, Lynn? All
yes.
Right, you got it. Dumb Donald is really dumb.
How dumb is he?
Thank you. I'll tell you how dumb he is. He has to use an instruction booklet every time he blinks. That's it. You got it. Very good. Yep. Splendid. Hello, Lynn. Dumb Donald is really dumb. He has to use an instruction booklet every time he blinks.
Goes to the bathroom.
What do you say, McLean?
I'll tell you what I say. You notice this jacket?
Yeah,
it looks
what is
like
that?
I'm growing little breasts.
Yeah.
You
are
say
you
boobs?
A 43 long?
No, I mean, it's just easier to unbutton this sucker, isn't it, when I'm sitting down?
I think, yes, and while you're seated, it would be better. Thank you. Oh, that looks
bra.
Better now.
I say to what she said, I have makes love.
Makes love is a good response. Splendid. Nedra?
Two minds with but a single thought.
You
makes
think...
love.
Uh-huh. Nedra?
Yes.
Do you think about it often?
Oh, I think about it.
Okay. Hello, Richard.
Hi.
How
Do
are
I
you?
Start writing now?
No.
Oh. Had you worried.
Yeah, you did have
okay.
you worried.
Okay. I was going to say what you said, but I didn't know how to put it. So...
You said...
Can't you read that?
Yeah, but you have to say it.
Gets dressed.
Okay.
Or puts his clothes on.
Right.
Or...
Hey.
Oh, hold on.
He's a big...
Why,
before
I ought to...
Before you're doing that, just a second here. Nedra.
What?
Would you come over here, please? Just... stand up. Do you realize he's as tall sitting down as she is standing up? He's taller than she is sitting down than he is standing up.
Don't sue me.
Sue, you're doing the best you can. Yes. We understand that.
I'm shrinking. Ah!
That's why I suggest you do not boo him. Dumb Dal Reedy, dumb, he has to use an instruction booklet every time he blanks. What do you got for us?
Well, you know, I think she really has a lot of nerve coming on a classy, tasteful show like this and saying every time he goes to the bathroom. And what kind of... I said goes to the bathroom.
Hello, Nathan.
I've been away for a while. It takes me a little while to get back into it. So, you know, I gave a little afternoon answer. I said,
let's see, ties his shoes. Yeah.
Hey. Stand up, Nathan.
You're not into the swing of it yet, but you will be, Nathan. Okay. Chuck.
Chuck says,
breathes.
Breathes. Another good one. So Lynn picks up one, Terry. Let's see how you do with yours. Fat Frida is so fat.
How fat is she?
You could open a blink in her belly button.
What?
That's how fat she is. You could open a blink in her belly button. That's how fat she is.
Wow.
All right, here we go, Terry. Fat Frida's so fat, you could open a blank in her belly button.
A restaurant?
A restaurant, Terry said. Anything. Round one questions are wide open. Whatever came to your mind, that's what you got.
You got it. Okay. Well, tough wackos. I said parking lot.
Parking lot.
That's very good.
That's fat.
That's
she was
human.
Big.
Fat.
Really big. Hello?
She's still fat. You could open a swimming pool.
Uh-huh. You've got the concave shape, Richard?
Well, I said she was so fat that you could open... First, I said a deli, but then I crossed it out. And I said you could open a soda pop.
Aha! Uh-huh.
In her belly button.
Yes.
Oh, come on. Now, that's funny.
And a good
sound effect,
too.
That would hurt.
That's twice you've booed Richard. He's keeping score, you know.
We've got to go backstage with him.
Right. Okay, John, you're up.
Yeah, well, I was going to say she was so fat you could open a Bowser mouth. From my previous life, but see, then I realized that no one is that fat, so I said restaurant.
Yay! Thank you.
Tie score. All right, Nathan, you're up.
I was trying to stay on Richard's good side, so I said deli.
Hey, deli.
Deli's a restaurant.
Close to a restaurant, but not a match. Charles?
She was so big, a shopping mall.
A shopping mall. So we've got a tight game going here. 1-1 the score. That's round one. Round two right after this. Here we go with round two. Since the score is tied and she went first last time, Terry will ask you to do it this time.
I'll have A, please.
All right. They both started with A in their rounds. Let's see what this says. Sylvia said, my husband works for Colonel Sanders and gets to take home all the parts they don't use. Every night he brings me a big bucket of blanks. Big bucket of blanks. Get away from the mic. Something like that, okay. That's what you want to do?
Of course.
Upper tier is ready. Lower tier is now ready. So, Terry, we come to you. Sylvie said, my husband works for Colonel Saunders and gets to take home all the parts they don't use. Every night he brings me a big bucket of blanks.
Feathers?
Feathers. That's good. Feathers. Inedible.
You mean they don't use the feathers?
So they don't.
Oh, I said bucket of beaks.
Bucket of beaks. Hey. One bucket of beaks to go. Good. Bucket of beaks.
I bet you know what I said.
Bucket of beaks?
No.
No.
Parts that go over the fence last.
They're rather tasty, as a matter of fact.
Oh, really?
A little fat, but tasty.
Feathers was my second choice.
Really?
Unfortunately, I went with my first choice.
What was that?
Necks.
Chicken necks.
Help!
Wait a minute, don't
He's
go.
He's got a following, though.
Take courage. No guts, Nathan. Come on. Get in there.
That's the answer. I should say guts. No.
What do you got? Stand up now, and
see,
take it like a man.
Once I got on the roll and thought I knew how the show was going to work, and then she says feathers. I said the part that goes over the fence last.
All right, that's two of those. And what do you have, sir?
The part that goes over the fence last.
That's it. Well, you had a lot of those over there. Did you think of that?
No.
Feathers, all right. Feathers is okay. Lynn, this is yours.
One to one.
Tommy Smothers said,
oh.
My parents always liked Dickie better. For Christmas, they gave him a pony and they gave me blank.
Blank is what I got on this one.
No pressure, Richard. You're the last
okay.
one.
I'm afraid one more boo and I'm out of here, right?
Yes.
You're on a roll, Richard.
Oh, I got it. They'll love it, really. I'm covered.
All right. Tommy Smothers said, my parents always liked Dickie better. For Christmas, they gave him a pony and they gave me blank.
A donkey.
A donkey?
A donkey? That would be a nice gift.
They're mean.
The question implied something, you know, useless or something that he didn't really know. A donkey wouldn't be bad at all. What came to your little
so
mind?
So William Morris agent wouldn't be out of line?
Great
something
insight.
Totally useless?
Yeah, cruel and useless.
No, just kidding, guys. I said the flu.
Splendid. You like that. They're your kind of people, McLean. Hello, Nedra.
Yeah, hello. I said a small duck.
A small duck.
It's hard to ride a small duck.
Right.
Almost impossible, unless Bear you're bet. Another duck.
Yes. All right. She'll be okay.
Yeah, it's all right.
We'll give her medication after the show. Richard?
Yeah, well, I said a dog.
Now, wait a minute.
Hey, you cut off his boo. What are you doing?
You believe me, see? A dog.
D-A-W-G.
A small dog.
You ruined his boo. Oh, there it is. Delayed boo.
What do you got?
Manure.
Manure.
Whoa.
One got the pony and the other got the other stuff.
One got the pony and one got the shovel and pail.
Aha. All right. Have some wonderful creative answers there. There we are at the end of round two. Still tied up 1-1. Third and final round right after this. Here we go. Third and final round. Bing. Still tied up. You went first last time. She goes first this time.
I'll take B.
B? Really? All right. Wow. In Texas, Tilly said, I just spent a week in the strangest hospital. You know how cowboy bars have mechanical bucking bulls? Well, this hospital had a mechanical bucking blank.
That's the longest question I've ever heard.
Where did you hear the sequel?
Hi, Gene.
What's new?
I'm feeling very well, thank you.
You working?
Yeah, well, so far, yeah.
Yeah, oh, okay.
You'll be seeing me in the second half of the show.
Oh, all right.
Until
how
then,
you?
I'm on hiatus.
Why, thank you. No, I haven't worked in 11 years. Thank you.
I'm going to be on McLean's new series, though, Jane.
What's that called?
Starts very soon.
Oh, all right. Ready, Terry, Lynn. In Texas, Tilly said, I just spent a week in the strangest hospital. You know how cowboy bars have mechanical bucking bulls? Well, this hospital had a mechanical bucking blank.
Bed.
Bed. All right, Lynn. Let's see if we get a bed up here. She's looking for a bed.
I know what she's looking for.
Give her a bed.
This is the same girl that went to the potty joke.
Right.
I said bedpan.
Bedpan. I don't want to be there. Nedra?
I'm half right. Bedpan.
Bedpan, right. Two of those.
Same deal.
Three bedpans in the upper tier.
Yay! I feel great.
They had a cheer up.
You say bedpan too. Four bedpans.
No waiting.
Chuck.
Bedpan.
Five.
Five bedpans, no waiting.
I would have said operating table or wheelchair or bed, but
that's
never
bedpan.
So
nice.
What do you say? Now, Terry, since it's still tied up 1-1, all you have to do is match one, and you will have won the game. The clerk at the Goodwill said, oh, boy, Johnny Carson must be desperate for tax deductions. He just tried to donate blank. Here we go. Terry, the clerk at the Goodwill said, boy, Johnny Carson must be desperate for tax deductions. He just tried to donate blank.
His ex-wife?
His ex-wife. Okay. That's what he tried to do.
Huh?
That's what he tried to do.
Yeah, but yeah. You see, she's not the ex-wife yet.
Oh, she's not.
No, no, they're still fighting over what it's just going to cost her to get by for a week.
I see.
Got it down to about $27 million a week, I understand. I put Ed McMahon.
Ed McMahon! Good one. You're right. His wife and Ed McMahon are the two.
I did, too.
There's two of those.
Wait,
Richard.
Hey, boo me this time, huh?
All right, that means Terry wins the game. Right there, if you would, please. Hey, Lynn. Don't go until I say goodbye. Pleasure to meet you. We're going to send you some gifts from the match game.
Thank
Lynn
you.
Klein, ladies and gentlemen. How do you feel?
Oh, I feel great.
Good. Well, now we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares. We've got the rest of the furniture coming in here. Three more stars will appear as if by magic. John and I will trade places. Lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Montgomery Ward's 19-inch color portable remote TV. Programmable remote system, 130-channel capability, automatic color system, and room light sensor. Furnished by Montgomery Ward. It's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Squares Hour with From Scarecrow and Mrs. King, Martha Smith, Larry Linville. From We've Got It Made, Bonnie Urseth. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bowman.
Okay.
And we'll be right back to play Hollywood Squares. Be with us.
Back to John Bowman and the Hollywood Squares.
Tough job. I have with me Terry Shodine, who made it through the match game. Congratulations. She is zipping right onto Hollywood Squares. We have three brand new celebrities, Bonnie Urseth, Martha Smith, and Larry Linville. Welcome. And Martha Smith. Boy, I have a dress just like that. I'm lucky I didn't wear
mine.
Yes, I'm lucky I didn't wear it today.
I was told this was original, too.
Listen, Martha, yes. You are on one of the few hits, really, for this television season, Scarecrow and Mrs. King. Yeah, among the new shows. Congratulations on that. What's in store for next year?
More of the same, except for we're going to be filming in Europe. The first five episodes we'll be shooting all over these wonderful locations in Europe, and then we'll be going to Washington, D.C. after that, and coming back to Burbank, lovely Burbank.
Oh, good for you. Ooh la la, we have a new location for you, my dear, right over here to play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. And we have a new opponent for you as well. He is our defending champ. His name is Scott Johnstone. He had a very nice day yesterday, and he's returning with 11,550 smackers. And some money, too.
Still getting ready for that big party, Scott?
I guess it's going to happen today, and oh my gosh, I'm not there.
Yeah, the big party. He announced yesterday he's going to have a big party at his house, and all the viewers were invited, and now he's got $11,000 to spend on it. He may have even more at the end of today after Hollywood Squares. We will play this game until you hear the time's up bell, and whoever's ahead at that point, of course, is our winner, goes on to play Super Match, up to $30,000. You won 10 yesterday. First game's worth 100 bucks, 25 for every square. Scott, pick a star and let's go.
Nedra.
Nedra Volz.
Yes?
According to the New York Times, this delicacy, taken from the ground, is popular in certain areas of the South. Is it baked clay or fried worms?
Well, worms aren't bad. Trust me. I was a judge in a worm contest one time. Yes, I was. So was Sarah Purcell, too. And Ken Toby, too.
What?
And I didn't win. But it really, the worms don't have any taste to them. You know, I see. We had a pizza recipe thing. It was delicious.
You got a while, Scott.
It was delicious. So I'm going to say it has to be worms because that other ground, what was that first thing?
Baked clay.
Oh, I never cared much for baked clay. But worms, delightful. I'm going to say worms.
Nedra says fried worms are a delicacy. Well, agree or disagree,
I'll
Scott?
Agree.
Baked clay is a delicacy. You should have disagreed.
Well, what does it taste like,
in certain
clay?
Areas of the South, baked clay is a delicacy. Sounds terrific. Terry, your move.
Charles, please.
Okay, you got one
got
up there?
Toothache. With my teeth, I baked clay, I'd go for the pizza, worm pizza. What, sweetheart?
Charles, in Japan, yes. McDonald's hamburgers Ronald McDonald is called this. Is he called Mitsui Tamashita?
Why is it always me?
It's one of these things, Charles. He's either called Mitsui Tamashita, Yo-Yo, or Donald McDonald.
It's three Z's. I'll go with Yo-Yo. I mean, wouldn't you?
You've done it before, you can do it again, right? Terry?
Yo-Yo.
Charles says that Ronald McDonald
one
is
yo
called,
for each arch.
Is called Yo-Yo in Japan. Agree or disagree?
Okay, let me clarify. There's three choices?
Yeah. Mitsui Tamashita, Yo-Yo, or Donald McDonald.
Like four.
Okay, I disagree.
Okay. In Japan, Ronald McDonald is called Donald McDonald. You were right to disagree, and you get the square. Very well done. Scott?
Thanks for your wife.
Pick a star where you'd like to place an X.
Bonnie to block.
Okay, the champ's in a little trouble right away. He misses this one. The first game belongs to the challenger. Bonnie Urseth, you are an ambitious executive assistant, and your boss asks you to pick up his dry cleaning on the way to the office. According to the book, Winning at Office Politics, should you do it? Or should you never let him think you're a toady?
A toady?
Yeah,
I would never let him think I was a toady. I don't... Oh, boy, I think once you start doing stuff like that, he just would maybe push you to the side. I'm going to say don't pick up the dry cleaning.
Don't pick up the boss's dry cleaning, she says. Agree or disagree to block, Scott?
I'll agree.
According to the book, Winning at Office Politics, you should pick up the boss's dry cleaning. Yay. Should have disagreed with Bonnie. Your opponent gets that square and wins the first game. Well, a clean sweep for you, Terry Shodine. You are relaxed now, I'm sure. We will find out what happens in a $200 game right after this. Mr. Goodson, your dry cleaning will be right over.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Oh, welcome back, everybody. Before we continue with the Hollywood Squares, it is my duty to inform you that the fabulous telephone match, which we had not too long ago on Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, is returning. Starting next week, we will give you the details of how to enter. What you can win is $5,000 and an appearance on an NBC soap opera. So it is well worth giving it a try. But I digress. We have a game 175 to Zippo. And Scott, you get to start a $200 contest. Pick a star.
Nedra.
Plenty
still
of time.
Trust
though.
Me, huh?
Let's go.
Okay. I never ate clay or anything.
Me neither. I never.
Who was Joanne Woodward talking about when she said, "It's a good thing he's handsome because he certainly can't act"? Was it John Travolta or Paul Newman?
Oh, it had to be John Travolta because she's married to Paul Newman, and if she said that, he'd kill her.
Agree or disagree, Scott?
No, she said...
She said that Joanne Woodward said about John Travolta, "It's a good thing he's handsome because he certainly can't act."
I'll disagree.
She said that about Paul Newman. You were right to disagree, and you get the square. That's logical. It was right after she ate the baked clay, Nedra.
Oh, I thought maybe it was just a joke.
No, this was her first impression of Paul. I'm sure her impression changed over the years.
Oh, well, you didn't say that, you rascal.
Sneaky, wasn't it? Terry, your move.
I'll go with Charles again, please.
Okay.
Wait, she comes to me. Yeah.
Mr. Nelson Reilly.
Yes, sweet.
You are a male bee.
Oh, another one of these. Go ahead.
Can you sting me if you want to? Or do only female bees have stingers?
Third grade stuff, and I don't get it.
You're so far beyond it, Charles.
I think they all sting.
Agree or disagree, Terry?
I agree.
Only female bees have stingers.
Whoa!
You should have disagreed with Charles. And Scott gets that square. So, you got a couple of X's up there. Are you back in business? Pick a star.
Bonnie to win.
Okay, this will give you the game and a lead. Bonnie Urseth from We Got It Made. You've got beans growing up your corn stalk. Is this good? Or will the beans kill your corn?
I should know this. Being from Minnesota, gosh, I used to spend summers on a corn farm. But all we had was just corn stalks. Didn't have any beans growing up them. I don't think you want beans growing up your corn stalks.
For the game, she says that you shouldn't have beans growing up your corn stalk. They'll kill the corn. Agree or disagree, Scott?
I'll agree.
It is good to have beans growing up your corn stalk.
Corn
she should have not, but she didn't. You should have disagreed with Bonnie, and your opponent gets that square and blocks you there. Well, big break for you, Terry Shodine. He could have put you away in this game, but he didn't. Pick a star for an O.
I'll have Jean, please.
You'll have Jean.
Be still my heart. She said she'll have me.
Jean, no one could be more ready to be had. Jean, was television's Emmy Award named after RCA founder David Sarnoff's wife, Emma, or after the Image Orthicon tube?
Well, I know that most of the viewers and the people gathered here in this room would not know, but... having been a guide in the NBC television tours in my youth, I happen to know that it was named after the Image Orthicon tube invented by Vladimir Zworykin, a distinguished RCA scientist.
Agree or disagree, Terry?
I agree.
It was named after the Image Orthicon tube. The right. Emmy was named, of course. Gene clearly knew that. I couldn't read him. That is correct. Why they didn't call it the Emmy, I don't know.
Thank you.
Wow. Scott, pick a star for an X.
McLean to block.
Yep, she's got you in that position, doesn't she? You missed this one. It's a pretty big lead for Terry. McLean Stevenson, what sex does Boy George list on his passport? You got three choices.
Oh, no.
I'm not getting male, female, or both.
You know, I knew the bean up your corn stalk. I knew the female bee. I knew the worm one. Was pretty sure that it wasn't Emma.
Give me a wild guess. It's either male, female, or both.
Okay. He lists himself. I know this. Because I read weird. Do you read it? It's all the rock groups.
Not lately.
It's quite good. He lists himself as a male.
Okay. Agree or disagree for a critical block, Scott?
I'll agree.
Boy George lists himself on his passport as male. Sure, that's why they call him Boy George. You're right to agree, you get the square, and you do block. So we got a thriller going, and we'll be back to complete it after these messages. See you then. 225 for the challenger, 75 for the champ. But we got a very tight $200 game going, and the last question was won by you, Scott, so it's Terry's move.
Richard, please.
Two.
Block.
Block.
Excuse me.
You missed this one, it's the game in the lead to the champ. Richard, in 1982...
I don't know!
Okay, in 1982, what were there more of in the U.S.? Accidents involving cheerleaders? Or accidents involving chainsaws?
What year was it they made that movie, you know, the one in Texas? Never mind. I'd have to say, those girls jump around a lot, don't they? I'd have to go with the cheerleaders.
He says there were more accidents involving cheerleaders in 1982.
I'd like
to block, agree or disagree, Terry?
I'll agree.
In 1982, there were more accidents involving chainsaws. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square, and your opponent wins the game. Let's get a good shot of what Richard's doing to his head right now. There were 10 times as many accidents. Quite a big difference. 10 times as many chainsaw accidents as cheerleader accidents. We will sweep the X's and O's off of the board because we got a real hot one going. It's a $300 game now. Pick a star. Terry.
Nedra, please.
Okay. Congratulations.
Oh, thanks.
You just became head cheerleader.
Oh, yeah. Chainsaws.
It's much safer than handling a chainsaw.
Yes.
Now, can your hair fall out from wearing it in a ponytail too much? Or is that just a lot of horse pucky?
I happen to feel that it's actually a ponytail. Because when you wear your hair back and in a ponytail, I don't know, but my hair comes out like crazy. And so I'm just going to say a ponytail because... That's all.
Because it seems like the thing to do. She says your hair can fall out from wearing it in a ponytail too much. Agree or disagree, Terry?
I disagree.
Your hair can fall out from that. No, you should have agreed with Nedra. And your opponent gets that square. So we're off to a good start in this game. Pick a star, Scott.
Gene.
Gene Rayburn for another X. In the wild, Gene, what does a polar bear mostly eat? Is it fish or seals?
In the wild, a polar bear. Their main diet consists of seals.
Agree or disagree, Scott?
I'll agree.
In the wild, a polar bear mostly eats seals. Right. Good for you. You're right to agree to get the square.
Save the polar bear.
Well, he is really charging from behind, and he's got two X's up there now. Terry, make your move for an O.
Larry, please. It's block.
Okay. You get this one, you block. You miss this one, it's a pretty big lead for Scott at this point in the game. Larry Linville, when the U.S. astronauts returned from the moon, did they leave behind a bag of trash? Or is the moon still litter-free?
There's so much human refuse from NASA on the moon, there's very little moon left. Yes, they left a great deal of trash behind them.
Agree or disagree, Terry, to block?
I'll agree.
They left behind a bag of trash. Yes, you're right, 3-3. You get the square and you do play. You sounded like you really knew. He seemed certain. $50 fine, you guys. Scott, your move. She thwarted you there.
Charles.
Okay. Charles for an X. You and your girlfriend, Nanette, are eating at a restaurant.
So far, so good.
Now, after the meal, Charles, she pulls a comb out of her purse. She asks if she can comb her hair. According to Emily Post, should you tell her okay? Or should you say, no, no, Nanette?
I think you should say, no, no, Nanette.
And do eight choruses and a tap dance.
What do you say, Scott?
This is after the meal.
Yeah. What concentration. Yes, this is after the meal. She wants to comb her hair.
I'll agree with Charles.
You should say, no, no, Nanette. You are right to agree with Charles, and you get the square.
All right.
Well done. He's got a slew of X's. Where would you like to place an O?
Bonnie to block, please.
Okay. Bonnie Urseth, your new baby parakeet, Peter, bites your finger every time you put him in his cage. According to Health Magazine, will he eventually calm down, or should you buy a glove?
I could get one from Michael Jackson, maybe. I think he'll eventually calm down.
She thinks he'll calm down. Agree or disagree, Terry?
I agree.
He will eventually calm down. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. So, you're stopped there, but you are maintaining your lead, Scott. Time is a factor. Pick a star.
Nathan to win.
Okay.
Nathan to win.
Lock you here. Nathan Cook, you're at the grocery store holding two oranges of similar size. Mm-hmm. One is much heavier than the other. Which one is juicier? The heavier orange or the lighter orange?
The heavier orange has got to be juicier because the water is heavier. This one with the thick skin is probably lighter. There's air in the skin. I'm going to go with the heavier orange is probably juicier.
To win, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
The heavier orange is juicier. Yes, it was not a trick question. You're right to agree. You get the square and you win the game. Well done. And the bell means that time is up. He has done it. Second day in a row. $700. Scott Johnstone is our champ. Good for you. You know what to do. Shake my hand, say goodbye to the losers, go over there. Join Gene Rayburn for your shot at the big money once again. And Terry Shodine. You built yourself up an early lead, but he did catch up and pass you and held on to it. You still played very, very well, and you're leaving here with $275. And our compliments, you're lovely, and thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares. Okay.
Here we are with the champ. We'll be back with him and our nine stars for a go at the big dough right after this for you.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
All right, here we go. He's ready. He's been through it once. He knows how it goes. It's the super match where he could win up to 30,000 clams. Ready?
You bet.
All right, here we go. Good luck to you. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank lunch. Remember, if you give us the most popular answer, it's 1,000. For the next one, 500. And for the third, 250. Whom do you call on?
John.
Out to lunch.
Out to lunch.
Nathan.
Have you got one, Nathan?
Yes, I will say a box lunch.
Box lunch. All right.
McLean.
Hello, McLean.
Hi, Gene.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good.
Love the bow tie.
Yeah, thank you.
Free.
Free lunch.
Yeah.
So those are the three you have. Thank you for noticing, McLean. Out to lunch, box lunch, and free lunch. Now, choose one of those or reject them and give us one of your own invention.
I'll go with out to lunch.
Out to lunch, John's answer. All right, let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal a $250 response. Hot lunch is up there. Not a bad answer.
Hot lunch.
The $500 one says free lunch. Well, we have that one from McLean. Uh-oh. Here's your last chance for out to lunch. No, slide the big one. Yay! Yay, Scott! Yay, Scott! Yay, Scott! And a way to go, Scott! Okay, you got the $1,000. Now it's time for the head-to-head with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, that star will pull a tab, reveal a hidden number, will multiply the $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. Whom do you call on?
I'm going to have to go with John again.
All right. Yesterday he had a 10. Today he has a 10. You like that?
That's just fun.
All right. Good luck to you, Scott. Here we go. Bath blank, B-A-T-H blank. Mm.
John made up his mind very quickly, Scott. It's up to you to collect the $10,000 by matching him. What do you say? The
only thing I can think of, bathtub.
Only? Oh, you don't like that?
Oh.
Heard a couple of people say, oh. A couple of you say, oh, what does that mean? I don't know.
It means there's a lot of dirty people out there. I never heard such groaning for such a brilliant answer. Bathtub.
And away to go, Scott. You now have a grand total of $23,250. Very good. We'll be back with a champ and the nine stars right after this. Here we go. We're now going to have the big reveal. Would all of the stars please grab the tabs and give them a yank? Ready, set, go.
Pull your tabs.
Larry. Larry Linville had it. The big 3-0.
Shoot.
Listen, I'm sorry to say. Bathhouse.
Bathhouse. Gonna whack you on the back.
Sorry to say that 2 days running, poor Martha hasn't been called out.
Let's cut that out. Now stop that.
McLean Stevenson said a moment ago, if she hasn't been called on for 2 days, she can wear the same dress tomorrow. Just something you'd like to say before we go?
Bye.
All right.
Clever.
We'll see you tomorrow, Scott. I'm Gene Raven inviting you to be there tomorrow.
John Bowman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares, Harris. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive this Montgomery Ward 16 cubic foot deluxe upright freezer. Features security key eject lock, power on signal, adjustable cold control, textured door, and adjustable shelves. Furnished by Montgomery Ward. For the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.